Welcome back, and we are way down south in the Mara Triangle. I got a report from one of my friends who's guiding from Serena, and he said, you've got to go, there's lion and leopard in the same place. The leopard has just disappeared behind this termite mound. Oh no, there she is. We're not very close to her at the moment, due to the fact that she's down in a little lugger, and it can make our signal and comms a bit difficult, but there she is. That looks like the Magia Chia, full female, but as I said, we are quite far from her. Now, she is slinking. She's already been put up a tree once today by the Purungut pride. And they're just on the other side of that lugger she's walking down. Craig's just going to show you where they are. They're all lying there, and there's about 14 or 15 lions spread out through this area. Are those more lions over there? Oh my goodness, there are. So she's actually got lions on both sides of her. There's more lions. It looks like lions over there. Yep, those are lions. Okay, let's just... Where has she disappeared to now? I'm just going to try to find her again. She's sneaking along the edge of the lugger. For those of you wondering what a lugger is, it is a little depression that holds water seasonally. Where has she gone? Now, of course, she's moving quite stealthily to try avoid all the lions that are around here. Let's see if she's got a bit further down. Remember, this is coming to you 100% live from Kenya. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go a little bit higher up the hill so I can see a bit more. Oh, there she is. There she is, on that big termite mound. She's trying to check where the lions are. Sorry about that, Craig. Hi, Melissa. Melissa's wondering if the Safari Live team has ever spotted a menelistic leopard. And the answer to that, Melissa, is an unfortunate no. It would be very exciting. They're incredibly rare. I have seen one in my whole life, and that was for about 5 seconds as it dashed across a road. No, she's just disappeared behind that termite mound. I don't think she's going to cross the lugger. I think she's just trying to keep in an area with the most cover. And she's going to be moving very cautiously and checking every moment. There's two male lions there and at least four lionesses on the other side, a bunch of cubs. There she is out. She's out on the move again. Just to the right of where she was. There she is. Now, I don't know if she knows about the lions that are on this side that we saw behind us. Where'd she disappear, Craig? She went back towards the lugger. Proud Cat Mama is wondering, are leopards faster than lions? Indeed they are, over a short distance. They have a better sprint, but not by much. And oopsie, there's a big termite on there. Let's just do this. Lions are also very quick. But what a leopard normally relies on is its ability to climb trees. And I heard that's exactly what she did to get away from them earlier today. She climbed a tree that's just up there, and she's now come down it, and she's slinking along. As I said, I've just lost sight of her again. Fortunately for her, the lions seem to have no interest at the moment. I hope she didn't cross, because it's quite a long way to find a spot to cross this lugger. We'll see shortly. Got her again. Let me just go forward. Jan says it doesn't look like there are many trees for her to climb, for her to be safe. Jan, you would, it's unbelievable what size tree a leopard will climb to get away from lions. They can go up the smallest of smallest trees. Just had her for a brief second. But you can see, she doesn't know about these lions in front of us here. I think there's actually more than I initially thought. 1, 2, 3. So there we go, there's 3 at least. There could be a few more. Dory's wondering, do I think she's on... Oh, you see more, okay? I think that was a bone. Is it a bone? It's a... Dory's wondering, is she moving to find a tree to climb? I don't think so, Dory. She's moved down from a tree, and she's basically just now trying to put distance between herself and the lions. Let me just have a quick look. Can you see her? I'm just gonna have a look at my binos and my far lookers. I don't see her. She was off to the right of where you are, Craig. There she's, oh, she's crossed the lugger. Oh, she is gorgeous. So she's crossed the lugger. Now, that doesn't mean there are no lions still. I mean, this is a big pride, and it's very spread at the moment. Let me go forward a bit. Hi LM. LM is wondering, how would lion cubs react to a leopard if they got left behind because the pride went hunting? Now, it all depends on the age of the cubs. If they're very young cubs, the leopard would actually kill them to try and remove that predatory competition that happens so often out here. So here we go. Here are these other 3 girls, all looking relatively well fed. Hi, girls. Oh, she's a pretty lioness, this one here. Doesn't like you moving the camera there, Craig. But there we go, she's calmed down now. I think she was just very fast asleep. Oh, you are gorgeous. Pretty, pretty lion. Now, I'm still just waiting for the leopard to pop out. Lots and lots of lions in this valley at the moment. Oh, that is beautiful. Late afternoon light just seeping through and giving us the most gorgeous picture of this girl. Beautiful. Christina is wondering, will leopards use the vehicle as cover? They might, Christina, but I think she'd prefer to use the lugger because of that water there, and there are trees and bushes that she might be able to scramble into to get away from the lions. Let's just have a quick look from here. Let us behave like a topi. Are you ready to be a topi, Craig? We're going to go up onto the termite mound to see if we can see a big cat. We are just toping about the Mara at the moment. Let's have a quick look if I can spot her again. Yeah, well, I'm going to try find this leopard again. While I do that, let's go back to Ali and see what she's up to.